I had like 4 years of piano, can't do anything. I could teach you.
Yes, sir.
Years ago, under Billy Smallwood, they had resettlement, where people moved from rural communities to more urban centers for education and health purposes. I don't know why education purposes. Newfoundlanders only go to Greek tree. So I live in the White Bay. It's Sheboygan V. My town is Abden, but up the bay on the west side is a place called Harbor Beach. So this young Newfoundlander, he was dying to go to Toronto because he had always heard about the bright lights of Toronto, which is where most Newfoundlanders go on the way to Forking Bird. So he gets a ride, his father takes him into Hampton. He gets a ride to Deer Lake, gets on the plane and goes to Toronto. He gets off the plane, the first day it's a shock to his system. He comes from a village of 200-250 to a city of over a million. And he hardly ventures out of the door. Finally, he gets to go out. And as the days and the weeks rolls by, he says, "Moy, I'm going to be my father's shop." He says, "I'm going to get him something special for Christmas." So he goes downtown to the Eaton Center. And he walks in the Eaton Center, and the first thing catches his attention is this big giant mirror on the wall. He had never seen a mirror before. He looks in the mirror and sees himself. But he had never seen himself before. He says, "Good grief, if I haven't seen myself before, I'm sure mother and father back home in Harbor Beach have never seen yourself either." So he buys a mirror and he packages it up. He sends it back home to his father and mother back in Aberdeen. His father gets a parcel, brings it in the house, opens it up on the kitchen table. It's a mirror. But he's never seen a mirror before. He looks in and sees himself. He says to his wife, Maggie, my dear, come over here, will you? And see how our poor son Johnny is ancient.
Oh my.
Thank you.
Yeah.